Hello, my name's Sarah Schofield. I'm a short story writer. In this video, I'll share some ideas on finding endings for stories. Endings can be difficult. Sometimes I've found myself going down dead ends, unsure what the story is about, and leaving stories unfinished, an incomplete collection of scenes or scraps of story. If this sounds familiar, I hope the approaches I've developed in my own work to find endings to tricky stories might help you. This is, of course, not a comprehensive troubleshooting guide, simply the start of some ideas that work for me and might work for you, or could give you a springboard to explore your own story endings. The shape of a story impacts on how it could end. So first, let's think about a couple of kinds of stories and how they conclude. One type is a closed story, sometimes called epical in shape. Something is revealed to the reader that makes everything clear. Something falls into place, or there's a moment of realization for the main character that resolves the story. You can find examples of these on the Comma Press website to see how they work. These closed endings include twist endings, where something hidden from the reader drops into place at the last moment. These are really, really fun to write, and generally you'll know what the ending is before you actually set out on writing it, so you can lay that double trail as you write. And I've always found the ending to these types of stories are easier because you probably know the destination before you embark on writing. The biggest challenge with these is to ensure that the reader doesn't feel cheated and is genuinely surprised by the ending. Some stories are open-ended. There's less closure. These stories are sometimes referred to as lyrical. It can be liberating to bear in mind that stories don't need to tie everything up neatly at the end. They can remain open to interpretation. Again, you can find some great examples on the Comma Press website of this type of story. As a first step, you may like to consider whether you tend towards writing epical or lyrical stories. Maybe take a look at the last few stories you've been developing, and you could chat about them with a writing friend and see what their take is. Having an awareness of what form your story is taking might help you shape its ending. But here are some thoughts on how I troubleshoot on endings if I'm feeling a bit stuck, and I hope this might help you too. Firstly, I ask myself, what's already in the story that I could consider returning to for the ending? I think of this as the inventory, and I list imagery, objects, details already contained in the story. I think our subconscious brain often already has the answer and has planted it like a seed already in the text somewhere. And our job is to sift through what is there to find the seed we already buried. Does this image or object or moment return to the closing of the story somehow? Alternatively, you might step away from the story and ask yourself, what does my protagonist really want? It might be something big like recognition or love, or it could be something tangible and simple like a cuppa or 5 minutes peace. It may be both something hugely existential and something small and simple. Once I've pinpointed what it is that they want, I consider whether or not they're going to get it at the end of the story. Or do they get something they didn't want? Or realise the thing they want isn't actually what they need. My next troubleshoot is to look at the opening of the story. Does the narrative come full circle somehow to end it? Is there a circularity to the story that feels right and satisfying? Again, your ending might be hiding in plain sight, right in those opening lines or scene. If I'm still stuck, I step away from the screen and go for a walk or a run and let my brain turn the story over as I move. The physical act of moving seems to free something up in the narrative, and often I find myself rushing back to scribble a revelation or a closing line or key detail that has surfaced. Alternatively, I sometimes sleep on it, holding the story in my mind as I go to sleep to see if I have a different perspective in the morning, and having let my sleeping brain untangle the puzzle of the story. This comes back to the inventory idea, seeing if your brain has planted that seed at the ending already. It might sound a bit daft, but movement and sleep both have helped me find key moments and endings to stories. It's definitely worth a try. A final note I try to always remember is, just like the coolest party guest, arrive late and leave early. Arriving late when the action is already rolling, and leaving early, end your story while it's still unfolding for the reader. Don't make them listen to the end rambling on like the last guest at the party. Leave them with the delight of the story, its full truth unfolding in their own minds. Often I chop the last few lines, even paragraphs, from the start and end of a work in progress. It's almost always improved for doing this. And lastly, I'd urge you to enjoy what you're developing. Stay on the page and give yourself permission to explore different endings. Writing a short story can feel risky and precarious. I often feel like I don't know what I'm doing or where it's going. Stay with it. Hold the spark that triggered your initial idea. Be bold. There isn't a right or a wrong way to do this. Trust yourself and trust your creative instinct and just enjoy it. Good luck.